Please tell us a few things about the experience, the previous experience in the previous period of financing programs in Romania.
Yes, with pleasure. We have had mostly good, positive experiences in our first financial assistance period ending in 2012. 85% of our funding was absorbed. I used to say slightly better than the absorption rate of EU funds.
Yeah, much better.
And we have had many projects which I think have contributed to tourism, to the economic and social growth, to the health sector in Romania. I could mention a few concrete examples, like the new administrative and research center at the Astra Museum in Sibiu, like the new National Center for Autistic Children in Bucharest, to mention an example from the health sector. Many very good business projects, like a new factory for producing medical equipment in Iași, a factory for producing juice and jam in Cluj, and approximately 60, more than 60 other projects. So we had, I think, a very good result from the first period of financial assistance. Now we are starting on a new period, which will see three times more money, and where we are just at the beginning of this new period of cooperation with Romania and Romanian partners.
So you said the absorption rate was very high in the previous
Compared
programs.
with the EU funds, it was very high. We hope in the new period to have 100% instead of 85%.
Can you make a comparison between the procedures in your financing programs and the European funds? Do you think that it's more simple to access these
I think
programs?
that's part of the explanation that our procedures were simpler, that we were more accessible. Our people had the general instruction to be very open and very forthcoming and should react quickly, not too much bureaucracy. We hope to keep it like this.
What else? What news can you tell about this the programs developing in this year? I understand you had to cancel some programs. Can you explain what happened to those and what happened
Yeah.
with this that fund, those funds?
Yeah. Regrettably, we had to cancel our biggest program. It's a very complicated program area. It's called carbon and capture storage. It has to do with CO2, global warming. And this program had to be canceled because, well, the basis for it simply disappeared, to put it in very simple terms. So this money, 40 million euro, has to be reallocated, and we are right now negotiating with Romanian authorities to find new fields for putting this money. We had also another big program, which was called Maritime, the Maritime program. To my surprise, that also had to be cancelled because there was not the necessary preparedness on the Romanian side to follow up on this program. So, to my surprise, that was not possible. So, also here, we are looking for other fields to spend this money.
Okay.
That was 15 million euro.
Okay. Do you have a message for potential applicants? Now we refer to the NGO fund because the questions were from our readers were directly
Yeah.
to this fund.
Yes, generally, I would say we are ve very happy that we have now provided the biggest source of financiation for the NGO sector in Romania. But I used to say, and I said it also at the launch, I hope also this fund will contribute indirectly or directly to the economic and social development of Romania. I'm not very fond of projects which mostly consist of conferences and seminars. We would like to see real results, concrete results to the benefit not only of the NGOs, but to the benefit of Romanian society and Romanians in general.